this picture represent the current situation of Japanese higher education and its reform. Very sorry, this is written in Japanese, but on the left, the person who raised hand is a university, or universities. And on the left, there are some powers colored by red, colored by blue. I don't want to say who this is, but someone say it's a Ministry of Education, or it's a industry, or it may be general public or parents of the students, but all require university to reform. Reform to what direction? Is that over there, behind the mountain, there may be a sunshine. That is a very, very bright future, maybe including digital society. I don't know. My impression that today there is a very sophisticated devices that simultaneously translate English into Spanish and also Spanish to English. I wonder that even the bad English translated into a very good Spanish or not. But I think that at the stage of the development of these devices, maybe bad English appeared bad Spanish, and good English appears good Spanish. So I'll try to speak good English as far as I can, but please understand. And before speaking about the digitalization of Japanese university, let me talk a little bit about my personal experience since the childhood, because I was born in 1949, and when I was a little child in 1950s and early 1960s, there were no electronic devices right now, just right now, only textbook and papers and pencil. And so, no electronic device, no digital devices. And our dream at that time is to get the very beautiful fountain pen when we become a junior high school student, presented by our parents. It was very expensive at that time. Maybe more than 12,000 Japanese yen. That means maybe 4,000 or 5,000 Mexican peso. So very expensive, but that is our dream at that time. But when I entered the, I got the first job at the Ministry of Education in 1972, digitalization gradually advancing. And every division of the ministry, there was at least one electronic character, a calculator, very big, but only one. So only one person can use that, and while others must use their own memory or Japanese traditional calculating tools we call soroban, to use the finger quickly and make a result. Most revolutionary events at that time was the invention of word processor, processor of Japanese. Because people say at that time, Japanese language is very different from Western languages. Your languages consists of only 26 or 27 or 7 or 30 different characters. But Japanese, we use thousands of Chinese character kanji, and also different kind of Japanese character, two different kinds of Japanese character. So they say it was almost impossible to make a typing, a good type. So Japanese language, using Japanese language made behind the digitalization of the society. But there was a breakthrough to use some AI, or at that time AI, to transmit the typing into a Japanese language. It was mid 1980s. Then Japanese language could join the global level of language suitable for digital age. I would like to describe the history of Japanese higher education very briefly in 5 minutes, only using three slides. Okay. First is that ancient Japan. We Japanese create our nation maybe 4th century or 5th century, according to the document made by China. And we have no our original characters, so must borrow character from China, Chinese character. The picture on the left is a book of poem called Manyoshu. It's a very old Japanese poem, maybe one of the oldest poems around the world, I believe. And they put Chinese character, but this Chinese character is not written in Chinese style, but we managed to read it into translation into Japanese. So using Chinese character, but our meaning is Japanese. In that way, we have learned a lot from China and also from other Western countries, but not so far away. Japan saw the globalization of the period, not just right now, but also in 16th and 17th century, there was a period of globalization for Japan. Because as you know, this century, the age of European voyages of discovery. So North America, Mid and South America, there were many European people sailing from European continent. And this picture, I don't know, you may know or not, but this picture is very famous among Japanese students, because we teach world history, and then sometimes in the textbook, this person appeared. This person's name is Tsunenaga Hasekura. He was a warrior or samurai sent by one of the daimyo called Date in the early 17th century to seek for the trading. And he firstly came to Mexico and then went to Rome, even Rome. But his mission was not successful because Japan at that time started to close their doors to the European countries and only trade with China, Korea, and Netherlands, Holland at that time. But After closing the doors to the Western countries, Japan developed our own culture and the science. And we call it the 17th to 19th century as the Edo period. This period, some people say it's a very feudal era, but some people say it's an early modern age, because a lot of scientific or artistic knowledge were developed in this time, and this is the basement of the establishment of the modern university, University of Tokyo, in 1886. And since then, Japan has expanded its higher education system. And now, Japan, we have about nearly 800 universities and also more than 300 junior colleges. And other vocational higher education level training schools we have a lot. And enrollment is about 3 million. And the university has a very important role for modernization of Japan, but also today, the university create knowledge by research and teach knowledge by teaching, and also dissemination of knowledge. We call it a social contribution. But in the digital age, however, knowledge should be dealt with a different manner. Because before, the university is the only place for, where knowledge has and knowledge should be disseminated. But in the digital age, knowledge is spread not only within university, but also outside university, or even in the global field. So Japanese university, as well as other countries' universities, must change their form. That we call that the university reform. So there are a lot of way of university reform, but in 2018, last year, National Council on Education, it's a very important council in Japan dealing with educational reform, have a report to the Minister of Education that the grand design of higher education in 2040. And this report, they call the new society as a society 5.0. Now 4.0, and next age is society 5.0. And society 5.0 means the fourth industrial revolution. First is agricultural, second is manufacturing, the third is information, and the fourth is the digital revolution, they say. And the main topics is that what this society will be, and how we should respond to, and how universities should train students for this change. Maybe we have already heard a lot of information about AI, big data, Internet of Things, IoT, or robotics, among the main concerns for those who are dealing with policy formation and also business management and university people. Sorry, this is not so clear because I borrowed this website issued by the Ministry of Education. And they say that this is a society 1.0. This is a hunting society, and society 2.0 is agriculture, and society 3.0 is manufacture, and society 4.0 is information age right now. But in the very near future, by 2040. There will be society 5.0, they say new society, where everything is connected through network or internet, and goods and information or other kind of things all combined with together, and we must live with this kind of new society. So, what university should respond to is that the teaching, research, and the social contribution all must be changed to adapt a new change of society. So I think that the teaching and research must be changed or must respond to. For example, teaching on AI. We should teach what is AI or how to work with the AI. And also, we must teach with AI, with the help of AI. It's a new devices or methods in the classroom, not only in the classrooms, but the laboratories or libraries, or even outside the university. But what I'm afraid of is that there will be the society where, at the university, teaching by AI, not human instructors. So we may lose our position. Many people may lose our position. But it is my question, so the answer is up to you. But how about traditional campuses or traditional curriculums, etc.? It's a great change, I think. And regarding research, research on AI or research with AI or research by AI. Research on AI, oh yes, it's a very good thing, but to research deeply what is AI and how we create or develop the technique or technology of AI or knowledge of AI and deeply understanding of AI and the human. Should AI wiser or advanced to that than humans? In Japan, there is a very popular word, singularity. That's the point of that AI pass above the human ability. I don't know whether it is true or not, but many people discuss about that. But also afraid is that AI may turn to the weapon without losing the human life. So AI weapon. So you can find the insect flying near you, but it was an AI weapon. It's very dangerous, I think. So I think I hear that there is a discussion, deeply discussion, that there is a movement of the international treaty to restrict the development of AI weapon. And research with AI, this is very great, I think. The few minutes ago, I saw the slide picture that your computer with a lot of bookshelves and many books are there. That kind of technique or technology is very revolutionary for a traditional way of research, because our traditional manner of research is that collect as much as we can and then analyze. But development of the AI, we need no more accumulate so much of volume of the book, because our books is just stored in the within this computer and with this in computer to other libraries. So this small computer is almost equal to the huge volume of the books and huge size of buildings. And that is one example. And also, what I'm afraid, and I would like to answer hear your answer, that research by AI, does AI make a research for you or instead of you? In some days, there is a paper, very sophisticated and very good, but in reality, it's written by AI, not by you. it is my question. So there is a lot of themes and the discussion, I think. But in my country, Japan, the discussion has just started. So we must pave the way to solve the various kind of problem toward 2040, when the new age of society 5.0 will come. Well, time is almost up, so thank you very much for your attention.